Out of the 8 billion people in the world, 30% of them have myopia. And Singapore has more than double of that rate, making it the myopia capital of the world.
By the time you turn 18, 4 out of 5 Singaporeans will have myopia. Why are Singaporeans' eyesight so bad? Today, we're gonna find out why. You know, the first time I got my own glasses, right, was when I was 13 years old, you know. Before that, I'll be seated at the back of the class, squinting my eyes off to see what's on the whiteboard. Can someone tell the teacher, write bigger a bit?
Amira, read what's on the whiteboard.
The lazy jumping on my mother.
Why are you reading so slowly? Can you see the whiteboard or not?
A bit harsh. Just like me, 65% of Singaporean children develop myopia from as young as 12 years old. And by 2050, more than 80% of Singaporean adults will have myopia. That's almost like the entire country, bro.
Who are you?
Sorry, Chair. The lazy brown jumping over my frog and the house and then...
The quick brown frog jumps over the lazy dog.
Oh, I see.
But how is myopia or nearsightedness developed?
What?
And how does it affect our vision?
Selfish,
Ideally, as we grow up, our eyeballs should develop into perfect spheres, giving us perfect vision.
Just like these basketballs. However, due to things like excessive screen exposure and bad working habits, you know your eyeballs are tired, no? Our eyeballs have to constantly adapt and stretch to focus on nearer objects. So from a round spherical shape, your eyeball lengthens to a rugby ball-like shape. And once this happens, there's no going back. You catch? So, the shape of our eyeballs affect our vision.
But my eyeballs and your eyeballs different leh.
Does myopia affect everyone the same way? Or does it differ according to what's being passed down from our parents? That's myopia. Run my gene. Get it?
Are we supposed to laugh or what?
Not funny meh? Okay lah, lame lah. Cut the camera.
If one of your parents is myopic, your chances of being nearsighted doubles. And having two myopic parents increases your odds by 8 times.
What is this low budget movie? Interesting, huh? Look at the actress.
While myopia is currently a global epidemic, it is more prevalent and severe among people of East Asian descent. One popular theory is that in ancient China, men with good eyesight were selected to go to war, where most of them died, leaving behind men with poor vision for the next generations.
But the rise in myopia rates affect all ethnic groups. So while genetics definitely does play a part, there are other reasons for our bad eyesight. For example, are you watching this in the dark, super close to your screens? You then ah.
Myopia rates in the world have risen far quicker than population growth. So, it can't just be genes causing it.
Generally, myopia develops among young children at about 7 to 10 years old. In Singapore, our children are very privileged and they get their first internet device at about 8 years old. They have a lot of school work as well. On average, Singaporean children spend about 9 hours of homework every week. Nowadays, there is a lot of home-based learning. They tend to use tablets at home for their school learning as well as computers. So kids are getting myopic at a much younger age, comprised of mainly environmental factors other than genetics.
So what happens if myopia is not curbed when we're young? And is there anything we can do to prevent it from getting worse?
If we don't intervene early at a young age, they are likely to develop high myopia later on in adulthood. With high myopia, it can lead to potentially blinding-related complications such as myopic macular degeneration, retinal detachment, and even glaucoma. High myopia is defined as worse than or equals to minus 5 diopters or 500 degrees.
Huh? 500 degrees? My degree already 450! What can I do to prevent it from getting worse?
Shall we go and get your eyes tested?
Let's go! So, Dr. Fu, how's my eye test looking like?
So the right eye shows that you have high myopia. You are at minus 5 diopter, 500 degrees.
This is not the goal I want to achieve in life, but oh my god. I am seeing several things here. on the screen.
So this is the image of your eyeball in cross-section. So what it shows that your length of the eyeball it is 26.15 millimeters long. The longer the length of the eyeball, the worse it is your myopia.
Okay.
We do see children at a younger age developing severe high myopia. The length of the eyeball can even go up to beyond 30 millimeters.
Oh my God.
Which is very concerning.
So what will be the average length of someone without myopia?
In general, for someone without myopia, they can range from around 20 to 24 millimeters. But it is age-dependent.
Age-dependent, okay lah. So Dr. Fu, what else does this machine do?
So this machine helps to chart and plot the degrees as well as the length of the eyeball at every visit. This allows us to understand better whether these children are at low, moderate or high risk of progression so that we can intervene early as well as change treatment accordingly.
So what are some ways we can try to control myopia?
We also have a range of myopia control treatment which we want to start the children on to slow down the rate of progression. And this treatment comprises of myopia control spectacle lenses, myopia control contact lenses, as well as atropine eye drops.
That's good. It's good to know that there's options out there for children to control myopia.
Definitely. We try to personalize treatment for every children as well as every young adult.
Nice.
While there's currently no cure for myopia, the least we could do is to go outside more. For children especially, just being outdoors for 2 hours a day can keep myopia at bay.
The more time spent outdoors, the more dopamine in the retinas is produced, helping to regulate and maintain the spherical shapes of the eyeballs.
And with Singapore's all-year-round sunlight, the difference between indoors and outdoors means that we can develop myopia more easily when we are inside! Get out, everybody! Get out! Get out! Get out!
And in sunny Singapore, the effects of outdoor light in reducing myopia are even stronger. The light from the sun can be up to 500 times brighter than indoor house lights.
Hey, I'm not talking, okay? I'm merely following my own advice to be out in the sun more. Remember to take care of your eyes, because it's myopia, not europia. Hey, I think I know that person.
Oi, Yang! Yang, oi! Oi!
I think he cannot see me. I think he got myopia. Oh yeah, I go chase after him.